Money, money, money. Money makes the world go round. Our everyday hustles at job, at home, revolve around either earning money or spending money. Today in this lesson, we are going to learn 10 phrasal verbs that are going to help you talk about money in your conversations. These phrasal verbs can add a dynamic touch to your conversations around finances. Welcome to Fluency Goals. I'm Mandeep. Before we go ahead with this lesson, I want to humbly request you to please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done yet. It's the motivation, the push that I need from all of you to help me keep serving you with valuable learning content. So let's begin the learning, shall we? Number one, fork out. Fork out. This phrasal verb is usually informally used to describe the act of paying money, especially when the amount is large and paid unwillingly. So in the situations where someone feels that they have paid too much or when their expense was not planned, you can use this phrasal verb. I had to fork out hefty sums for the unexpected medical bills. So the person is not willing to pay such hefty amount of money for the medical bills that he was not even expecting. Since our old air conditioning unit malfunctioned, we had to fork out for the new air conditioning unit since the summers were unbearable. So again, unwilling expenditure of money. Number two is payback. Payback. So whenever you're talking about repaying the money that you borrow, you can use this phrasal verb, payback. So use it in the context of settling debts or loans. I need to pay back the money that I borrowed from my friend next week. She plans to pay back her student loans within 5 years. Number three is cash in. Cash in. So when someone wants to liquidate an asset, say bonds, shares, casino chips before the expected time, you can use the phrasal verb cash in to talk about that. They decided to cash in on their bonds and spend the money on holiday. She's going to cash in her life insurance policy early for some extra cash. Number four, save up. Save up. So when you put aside some money gradually for some purpose to spend it later on a purpose, you can use the phrasal verb save up. I'm saving up for a trip to Europe next summer. He has been saving up his pocket money to buy a new electric guitar. So opposite to save up is shell out. Shell out. Shell out when you have to take out some money for some expenditure. So that expenditure that is done unwillingly on your part, often because it is unexpected or at some unwanted cost. They were reluctant to shell out for a new software update, but it was important for security reasons. The concert tickets were expensive, but we decided to shell out because it was once in a lifetime event. Number six, rake in. Rake in. Rake in is used to convey the idea that somebody is earning a large amount of money with little effort and within a short period of time. So it is typically used in business or sales contexts where there is a significant profit or income. The new restaurant is so popular that the owners are raking in profits faster than they expected. Her latest novel was bestseller and she has been raking in royalties ever since. The app was a hit and the developers started to rake in money from the downloads. So use this phrasal verb when discussing financial success. Number seven, takeout. Takeout. Takeout is used to convey the idea of withdrawing money from the ATM or taking a loan or debt from some bank. I need to take out some cash for buying groceries. Before going on vacation, he took out a large sum of money from his savings. Number eight, payoff. Payoff. So when you finish paying the money that is owed by you to someone, you can use the phrasal verb pay off their. After years of saving, they finally managed to pay off their mortgage. He worked extra shifts to pay off his car loan early. Now, this is the usage of pay off in context to settling debts. But payoff can also be used in the context where you want to convey that an investment or an effort has started resulting in positive outcomes. The gamble paid off and they made a substantial profit. All the expenditure on advertisement paid off well as they got a number of new clients. Number 9, ripoff. Ripoff. So this phrasal verb is often used in the situations where the customers feel that they have been cheated on financially and the company or the shop owner have charged them a hefty amount for something or for some product that was of poor quality. So this phrasal verb is used especially in terms of pricing where the customers feel that they have been taken advantage of. It's not fair to rip off customers by charging them for the services they didn't receive. Tourists often feel ripped off when the local cab drivers charge them exorbitant fares. I can't believe I was ripped off at the electronics store. The phone that I bought last week has stopped working already. Number 10, chip-in. Chip-in. So when you contribute money to a group in order to pay for something collectively. So when you are making that contribution in the collective payment in a group, then you are chipping in. We all chipped in to buy a gift for our teacher. I chipped in my $100 for the treat. So that was all about using phrasal verbs to discuss money matters, to discuss finances. If you have liked this video, then please give a like, do share it with your friends, and if you haven't done yet, then please subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next week with another lesson. Till then, happy learning.